I've read some impressive claims online from users of Motomix, an alkalite-based, highly refined, not to mention incredibly expensive, fuel for two-stroke engines by Stihl. And one of these claims that I've got reservations about is how many of the users state that it's actually started to clean their engines of carbon by simply running it instead of the regular pump fuel that we can all get access to. On today's short video, I'm going to test this claim on the two-stroke engine inside this leaf blower. And we'll start with disassembling it so we can get a really good close-up of the carbon on the piston crown, skirt, cylinder head, exhaust port, spark plug, and anywhere else I can find it. Comes. Okay, good. Let's get you in nice and close. So we have, this is the exhaust side skirt, and you can see we've got a small amount of blow-by, so maybe the fuel will clean that up. Small amount of blow-by at the bottom, and also a little bit up here. We've got a small amount of carbon formation above the ring and ringland, and also on the side above the ring and ringland. A little bit, again, blow-by down there. Not much else to speak of. The piston crown, it seems to be really thin because you can see through it in certain areas. Intake side, no real blow-by to speak of. Maybe a tiny amount up here in the top left-hand corner below the ringland. No carbon to speak of above it. Oh, in fact, actually, I'll take that back. A small amount there. Cylinder next.
All around the squish band, right round to the threads as well. In fact, there's a small lip of carbon on those threads.
And the exhaust port next, there it is. So what looks wetter and darker, that's actually the aluminium from the cylinder. And of course, the lighter gray is the carbon. Spark plug. So it looks like we've got a fair bit of carbon building up around the base of the threads. Ground strap looks okay. Center electrode looks okay, just a light dusting of carbon.
Okay, start the time lapse now.
So about half an hour ago was when I turned the machine off, and we're about 55, 65 on the muffler, 70 on the fins, and about 60 on the spark plug. So it's been a total of 1 litre, 2 hours run time, and that equates to 2 tanks on this machine. So let's tear into it and we'll see what we find. So, actually, there might have been some cleaning of the carbon on the bottom part of the exhaust port. I'm going to have to check the photos, but it's a good start. Nothing on the roof of the exhaust port. That looks the same. But possibly on the base of the exhaust port. Let's keep digging into it.
Here we go.
Piston crown. I'll be honest, I don't see any difference from memory. I think that was already there. So I would say there's really nothing to speak of on the crown.
Then on the skirt, let's give it a clean off. I can't tell if it's removed any carbon or blow by, I should say. I can't remember if there was any up there. So we're gonna have to go by pictures, but above the ring land, you can certainly see it's removed the carbon. I'm fairly confident that that used to all be black from about there to there. So it hasn't affected this small portion, but this certainly has. Intake, I think beforehand there was a small amount of carbon here and it was very faint, but actually that's disappeared. Or I should say it's much fainter, I think. But yes, without question, that has cleaned up there. And I seem to remember there being some sort of blow-by here, and that's cleaned that up as well. Again, we're gonna have to check the photos. Nothing's jumping out at me, I must be honest. It looks very much the same. I'm going to say inconclusive on that. Maybe slightly, not enough to say for definite. So firstly, on the exhaust side, piston skirt, and I think we can all agree that there's been a noticeable reduction in the amount of blow-by that's remaining after running that Motomix. Certainly looks like it's been cleaned up. Now, the second photo of the exhaust port, I'd actually noticed that it's the angle and the perspective of the two photos look a lot cleaner. And if I overlay now what the exhaust port looked like before we ran the Motomix from a slightly different angle, you can see it's almost identical. So don't be fooled here. There is very little, if any, difference before and after. And then lastly, the spark plug. So these were the three areas that I thought may have had the most notable change in carbon. Again, the spark plug slightly lighter. It was probably because I had given it a better tune than what it was running on by the previous owner. But realistically, very, very small amounts, if any change, in my opinion. Now, this is only 1 litre, a couple of hours of running, so take it for what it's worth. Let me know in the comment section below what you think. Has it made any difference, or has it not really changed anything at all? And one quick note, when we're tearing engines apart for repairs, you always run the risk of damaging them, that you might cross-thread something or cause more problems than you solve. In some instances, you don't have to take the engine apart to be able to affect that repair. And one of those instances I've got on video right up here for you next. I hope you've enjoyed today, and I'll see you over there.